Primary days a week away, and Virginians will be picking both the Republican and Democratic candidates for governor. Two men are vying on the Democratic side, three on the GOP side. Here to break down both races is our esteemed political analyst, Dr. Bob Holsworth. Bob, welcome as always.
Great to be here tonight, Bill.
Well, let's start with the Republicans. Three people. Ed Gillespie, the former RNC chair, he is running. He gave Mark Warner a great race for Warner's Senate seat when Warner was the incumbent
two years ago.
Very close. Senator Frank Wagner and Corey Stewart, the former Trump Virginia chair who was fired. Tell me, what do you see in that race right now?
Well, I really think that Ed Gillespie is probably clearly in the lead here, and it'd be a big, big surprise and a huge upset if either of the two other candidates were able to win on Tuesday night. Gillespie, as you said, ran so close against Mark Warner in 2014 that a lot of people think he's probably the Republican who would have the best chance of winning. And I think Frank Wagner, a good senator from Virginia Beach, has had difficulty, I think, getting statewide traction.
Getting known outside.
Corey Stewart, who's the chair of the board of Prince William County Board of Supervisors, ran this odd campaign, really defending Confederate monuments and Confederate symbols, saying he's proudly politically incorrect, trying to do in some ways what Donald Trump did. But I think he's going to have a tough haul as well, Bill.
So does Donald Trump as president affect Republican turnout? I mean, would there be those who are, you know, happy with the way things are as Republicans, or is he not even an issue among Republicans who are going to come out to vote?
You know, I think Gillespie's big worry right now is probably the turnout. About, you know, does people think that he has such a big lead in these polls that they won't show up? My sense is that Trump has not been really involved in this, and ironically, he's been much more involved, you might say, on the Democratic side, because they're all running against him for the Democratic nomination for governor.
Right. Well, let's go to that then. Former Congressman Tom Perriello against the incumbent Lieutenant Governor Ralph Northam. What do you see there?
Well, I think what you see here is that Tom Perriello is kind of running as a Bernie Sanders progressive candidate. He got in the race a little late. He waited until after the 2016 election. Northam had already had the support of much of the Democratic establishment. So that's what we're going to see on Tuesday night. All of the establishment figures in the Democratic Party, the governor, the two senators, the legislative black caucus, they're all behind Northam. And if they can turn out the voters, it's going to be an uphill climb for Perriello. What Perriello has done, however, is that he's gotten people from outside. Bernie Sanders,
Elizabeth
Warren.
Does that have an impact, though, in an in-state primary? I mean, is that energizing
the
base?
Well, it might have some, because there are a lot of progressives who are really anti-Trump, who love Bernie Sanders, maybe the most popular Democrat right now in America. Elizabeth Warren, pretty popular among Democrats, so she's a polarizing, controversial figure elsewhere. And so Perriello's doing what he has to do in some ways, because Ralph
Northam.
He's got
to distinguish himself and separate himself.
Yeah, and Ralph Northam already had all the Democratic Party politicians in Virginia. So Perriello's done a great job in getting some outsiders. He's trying to appeal to young people, let's say college students, but the challenge there is many of them registered on campus in 2016.
And school is out.
And school is out. They're not going to be there. So we're going to have to see whether Tom Perriello can come from behind, and whether that sort of progressive momentum that we're seeing across the Democratic Party nationally manifests itself in Virginia on Tuesday, Bill.
So, and who typically is going to come out to vote in a primary like this? I know we're kind of in uncharted territory with the Trump election, and maybe that's thrown a curveball even into state politics, but and it's the summertime. Who votes in these things?
There's not many, Bill, that, you know, sometimes the turnout is 5%, 6%, very rarely more than 10 or 12%. So that's why it's so hard to predict these races, because you really don't know who's going to show up. And sometimes the person who has the most committed, passionate followers can do pretty well.
All right. Thank you, Bob, for your insights, as always.